All right, we'll get started here. There we go, guys. Gotta be careful, it's kinda hot. First of all, I'd like to thank everyone and take this opportunity to welcome you all to tonight's award tonight. A time for us to recognize our students and athletes and their accomplishments this year. Sometimes we gather to celebrate great accomplishments. Sometimes we gather to celebrate great team accomplishments. We're not always going to be state champions, but we're all going to have successes in the years that we have. That's the great thing about sports and education. How many times have I preached to you guys, you get out of it what you put into it? How many times have you heard me say that? A few times? You're a liar, Boston. Probably only a couple hundred times if you've listened to me, which you're probably right, Boston. Not Boston, no. He does listen to me. Our seniors who graduate this weekend have left their lasting legacy on HTHS, just like many of those who have gone before you. I'd like to take this opportunity to personally thank each and every one of you for your hard work and contributions to make our school what it is today. So I'd like to give them a round of applause. Tonight we honor not only our seniors, but also those who helped to shape our program and our school and to acknowledge their accomplishments. Sports are an extension of our formal education. You learn many life lessons away from the classroom. It teaches you skills that you will use the rest of your lives. You'll look back on all the ups and downs. Some of you will have regrets, some of you will not. For your seniors, it's the end of the road. But for the others, the journey is only beginning. I've told a lot of you a number of times through the years, when it's all over, you want to be able to look back and say, I wouldn't change a thing. I put forth my best effort in everything that I've done. So hopefully you seniors have accomplished that. And for you who are still here, take those words and build on what you've accomplished already and make your legacy, because some of you have 1 year, some of you have 4 or 5 years left. So what are you going to do with the time that you have? Parents, fans, I'd like to thank you for all the support that you've had throughout the years, for the year this year, for coming to all the games, meals, any support that we've needed. We really appreciate that. It takes a lot for things to work out in a small school. And to have the support that we have throughout the Hitchcock and Tulare communities is very, very well appreciated by us coaches, by the staff, by the school, that we have the support of our community like we do here. And that's one thing that, you know, every time we go somewhere, I think I say this every year, when we go to places, win or lose, whether we have the great teams or whether we don't have not so great teams, we always have the support of our family, our friends, our fans, and everybody. So that's one thing that we want to express to you, that we love to see that, we like to continue to see that. And we always have good kids. Every time we go someplace, we always preach, you know, please and thank yous, you know, pick up your mess, and we get compliments on that from our kids. A lot of times we don't have to do anything. We were at a track meet the other day over in Miller, and two or three elderly people came in, and the first thing our kid says up front, you guys get up here, and they're like, no, no, no. Yep, get up there. And, you know, those are things that's not overlooked, and other communities see that. And it doesn't happen everywhere, because we go in there with the same group of teams from other places, and that don't happen. And I thank you for all that. I thank you for your hard work. We're here also to look at our academic, our scholarship for our seniors, all their accomplishments that they put forth. So hopefully it'll be a good night that we all enjoy. We go away from here. Some of you will go away smiling. Some of you will go away crying. But like I said before, if you've accomplished everything that you wanted to, this is a happy evening for you. So we'll get things started off with the presentation of the Heartland State Bank Scholarship. And that'll be presented by Bridget Nelson.
All right. Heartland State Bank. I'm happy to present three scholarship awards tonight. The first two will be for $250 each, and it goes to Grayson Binger and Jordan Michelin. And the third one will be for $500, and that goes to Shaylin Steinhauser.
The next scholarship to offer is the CIS scholarship, and our presenter is Amy Miklich.
Each year, Sisters in Spirit offer two scholarships to the Hitchcock Tuller seniors. These scholarships are in memory of former Tuller residents Carl and Omer Olson, Robert J. Schultz, and Ty Jan. Each scholarship is in the amount of $100. This year's recipients are Boston Knibling and Caitlin Boomsma. We wish you happiness and much success in your future.
The next award we have is the Paul A. Scheller VFW Scholarship. It goes to a graduating senior boy and girl who excelled with a combination of both athletic and scholastic achievement. They go to Jordan Miklich and Shaylin Steinhauser. Next, we'll have the Hub International Bank of the West Scholarship, presented by Dave Willis.
Actually, some of you know me in the room, not all, but this is probably a hard thing for me to do, is because I really do honestly think that all of the seniors, and especially the ones that sent in for the request, deserves this. But Hub International used to be VW Insurance and Bank of the West. They have to make a decision, and our decision for 2015 is Grayson Binger.
Our next scholarship is the Lee Schlegel Memorial Basketball Scholarship. Each year our kids have the opportunity, over probably the past 4 or 5 years, we've had the opportunity to go over and play in the Clark JV basketball tournament. Many of our seniors and a lot of our younger classmen have had the opportunity to participate in this. And in return, the family pays back to the school. For those seniors who apply for the scholarship, they pay that back to represent their son. I'll read a little bit about him because, you know, it's kind of a special thing, somebody whose life ends so soon. The Lee Schlegel, son of Terry and Deb Schlegel, was an outstanding athlete at Clark High School. His life ended as a result of an asthma attack at the age of 25. While attending Clark High School, he excelled in sports. He was quarterback on the 2002-11B state championship football team and a key player of the basketball team that was runner-up to Chester in 2004. In track, he was a member of the state championship medley relay team his senior year. Lee was at his best when the game was bigger and more important. He was a player you could count on in big games, thriving in situations where there was an opportunity to do something special for his team. The Lee Schlegel Scholarship this year goes to Shaylin Steinhauser. Next, we'll have the Tulare Legion, Bob Bruning, present the award.
The American Legion would like to congratulate Craig Mallon for the 2016 Boys State Delegate. Mark Earl Hoffman, post 292, gives a scholarship every year, payable second semester. This year's scholarship goes to Jordan Meplick.
Next, we'll have the Tulare Auxiliary. Susan Sires will present those.
Tulare American Legion Auxiliary chose Corey Cheddar as our Girl State Delegate this year, and April Hamilton as our alternate. And our $250 scholarship for the graduating senior will be Chelsea Schultz. We have our Americanism essay each year. And it was, how do we keep Lincoln's promise to our veterans and their families? Peyton Nelson got first place in class 4, ninth grade. Bailey Vayner got first place in class 3, eighth grade. Kennedy Enander got second place class 3, seventh grade, and Dawson Otto second place class 4, ninth grade.
The Hitchcock representatives for Girl State are, the Girl State nominee is Kylie Gross, and the alternate is Aaron Berry. And the Hitchcock American Legion Auxiliary awards a scholarship, and this year goes to Clay Martin. Next, we'll have the Alan Lynn Schultz Memorial, and that'll be presented by Ms. Copeland.
Alan and Lynn Schultz both graduated from Tulare High School. Education was important to them as they evidenced with them both attending college and pursuing careers. Alan as a teacher and Lynn as a nurse. When they moved back to Tulare, Alan served on the community Tulare School Board. The scholarship was founded by Lynn in honor of her husband after his passing. This year is the first year it's given in honor of both Alan and Lynn. This year's recipient of a $1,000 scholarship is Chelsea Schultz.
Next up, Mr. Brink will present National FFA Scholarship.
Thank you. At this time, I'd like to recognize a scholarship on the national level. The National FFA organization recognizes seniors that excel in leadership, scholarship, and activities. And we have a student, Chase Vixler, that receives a $1,000 scholarship from the National FFA. Congratulations.
Next, we'll have a scholarship that will be presented by Alex Rober for the Masons. They'll give a scholarship out here.
Good evening. On behalf of the Tulare Masonic Lodge, we have two $300 scholarships to give out tonight. I proudly present these scholarships, one to Shailen Steinhauser and Chase Pixler.
The next scholarship I will present is the Dakota Energy Cooperative Scholarship. It is for $500. And that scholarship goes to Clay Martin. Next scholarship is the First Presbyterian Church and Dorothy Lynette Scholarship for $750. That scholarship goes to Clay Martin. The Lions Club at Lions International have given out some certificates of appreciation for some of our young students. This particular award is for the Lions International Peace Poster Contest. It's a certificate of appreciation for what they do as a student. And I have three to give. Ashley Godfrey. Second one goes to Caitlin Afton. And
to Jameson Ryan. The next one here, the business club is a new scholarship here. It was actually created by our business classes. Our students have what I like to call an eating fetish, and they eat all the time. So Mr. Vincent and his business classes basically said, let's put the money to a good cause, and whatever snacks or fulfilling substance they put in their bodies, they paid for. They tallied all that money up at the end of the year, and we're going to give out 2 scholarships to seniors on that behalf. The first scholarship that will be awarded for this particular club goes to Grayson Binger. And if I remember, his was for $113. Well, that'll pay for 1 book for you next year. Good job. And the next scholarship, the same business club scholarship, is for $250, if I remember correctly. And that goes to Caitlin Boomsma. And corrected me, that would be $225. So I owe you $25. Next one is our academic letter winners. All of our students have already received those certificates on their table. I will read those names out loud here just to recognize our young students. To qualify for this, you needed a 3.5 grade point average for the year or better. We have quite a list here, so that really demonstrates that our young people are really striving at an academic level. So I'm just gonna go through the list here. Seniors were Grayson Binger, Chase Bixler, Caitlin Boomsma, Boston Knipling, Jordan Michlick, Sage Peterson, Chelsea Schultz, and Shaylin Steinhausen. The juniors, Aaron Berry, Riley Binger, Cassie Buchholz. What happened? Sky Chaplin, Kylie Gross, April Hamilton, Craig Mallon, Shanae Peterson, Kennedy Tomsha, and Corey Chatter. Sophomores, Allie Binger, Cameron Binger, Peyton Binger, Bailey Cole, Bailey Enander, Brittany Hofer, Ashlyn Otto, Tyler Schoen, and Caleb Warner. And the freshmen were Grant Hamilton, Chelsea Hofer, Isabel Close, Christine Michlick, come on, Peyton Nelson, and Dawson Otto. If you do the numbers there, it's about 33. That's excluding, obviously, our junior high, which hasn't qualified yet, but they will. Something I would like to bring up here to show you the competition that our young students have for academics. Just looking through our grade point average, our seniors will be graduating here soon. Our upcoming seniors, you can go 9 deep into their graduating class next year, and you are still at a 3.8 grade point average. That is very, very impressive. So good job, juniors. Okay, we have 2 very special awards here to give. As you know, Saturday at 2 o'clock is our graduation for the class of 2016. So with that said, I'd like to present two awards here. Recipients will see a fairly heavy medal with a very nice lanyard that goes with it. And this year's graduating class of 2016 salutatorian is Chase Kixler. And our valedictorian this year is Shaylin Steinhaus. The next thing I'm going to offer is the gold tassels to our seniors who are graduating that have high honors or honors. To receive high honor, you needed a 3.67 or higher. And to receive honors, you needed a 3.33 to a 3.66. So receiving high honors, Shaylin Steinhauser and Chase Bickler. With honors, Grayson Binger, Boston Knippling, Jordan Miklich, Sage Peterson, and Chelsea Schultz. Okay, next up we will present some organizational and team awards. Up will be oral interpretation and Ms. Pepper.
The Hitchcock American Legion Auxiliary does the essay and the poppy posters as well. First place in class three was Gabe Clark. Second place in class three was Titus Waldner. First place in class four is Grant Hamilton. And second place in class four is Brittany Holfer. And the last essay, class five, Chase Bixler. Poppy posters, class four, first place, Danielle Wright. And class four, second place, was Ashley Godfrey.
Contest. At least one. And they didn't like it much. Class time was fun. show you something. Would the sophomore class please stand up? All of you. These students went to competition and survived, and for that they deserve a round of applause. When I announced 7th and 8th graders were going to go to an oral interpretation contest. So 7th and 8th graders, stand up. So these are your representatives that will be your new speakers. Most of them did quite well. We brought home some superior pluses, a lot of superiors, and you should be proud of these guys for going out and speaking in front of strangers. Thank you to all you guys who are great to work with. I do have one person I do want to recognize. This person received a superior plus in Florence, made it to grand finals at Dakota State University, received a superior plus at districts to advance to regionals. At regionals, this person got fourth and advanced to state competition. And so I'd like to present Brittany Hofer with a pin for her excellent competition skills. We'll have it tomorrow. So, for you who don't know, these will be the people that are putting together our yearbook to represent our school, the changes that happened throughout the years, and how they want you to remember them. So, pins go to Kylie Gross,
next up, I'd like to present the Hero Honor Award recipients. It deals with organizing and donating blood for a good cause, obviously for the blood drives that we have here. So I have a few recipients that will receive a red cord that will go on their graduation gown. Chelsea Schultz. Clay Martin. Clay did a selfless act by donating 3 times to receive that. So nice job, Quinn. And the last one is Dave Peterson. Next up will be the FCCLA and Ms. Hollister.
We had 16 students participate in FCCLA this year. 15 of these students attended the state meeting in Sioux Falls at the end of April. Their certificates are at their seat, but would you please stand as I announce your guys' results? Tiana Dam and Danielle Wright, bronze. Kylie Gross, Aaron Berry, and Ashlyn Otto, silver. Corey Cheddar and Caitlin Boomsma, gold. And they also received the top superior. Shanae Peterson, Dawson Otto, and Trajan Flea, gold. And they also received the top superior. Kennedy Tomshaw and Cassie Buholtz, gold, top superior. You can stand up. These two were also in the top two in the state and had to participate in runoffs. And finally, Peyton Binger and Craig Mallon received a gold top superior. And these two were the winners of their project area and will be traveling to San Diego in July for the National FCCLA Conference. An outstanding FCCLA member and an honorary member. This year's outstanding FCCLA member was the individual who worked behind the scenes when I was not here at the beginning of the year. She spent many hours helping in the concession stand, organizing the Crush Pop fundraiser, and working on her star event. She's also this year's chapter president. This year's outstanding FCCLA member goes to Corey Cheddar. This year, while I was student teaching in Redfield, this individual worked in the concession stand, helped start star events, and was always volunteering to help. She chaperoned and judged at state convention this year, and she will be judging at the National Convention for South Dakota in July. This year's honorary member goes to my aunt, Debbie Beeger. Next up is our music awards, presented by Ms. Miller.
I'd like to start by awarding our four members that represented your school at All-State Chorus and Orchestra in Rapid City in October over Halloween. Those go to Brittany Hofer, Chelsea Hofer, Peyton Nelson, and Ty Hofer. Yeah. each year, students in the field of music. Some excel really well, some like to be there, and they do help out. I would like to award one member from the high school and one member from the junior high who have, in my opinion, they excel as far as they are interested in what they do. They work hard for what they put out, and they are a big help in being a mentor to the others that are there as well. For my band members for the high school is Kobe Stoner. And for the junior high, Wyatt Bricker. I look for the same in choir as well. And this year for the high school will be Peyton Binger.
Will Mr. Hall come forward to present the Drama and Play Award?
Okay, can I have everyone that was in plays come up and stand behind me by class? This year we did one-act play. It was called Virgil's Wedding. And I'm going to have a daughter that's going to be married in about 2-3 weeks. I hope the wedding is nothing like what our play was. I'd like to introduce first the freshman, Ashley Godfrey, Amanda Hosel, Christine Miklich, Peyton Nelson, Dawson Otto. And then we had, I think, 8 sophomores out this year. Allie Binger. Cameron Binger. Peyton Binger. Zach Binger helped out with lights and sound. Bailey Enander, Wyatt Johnson, Cole Conan, Tyler Schoen, and juniors Aaron Berry, Riley Binger, Sky Chaplin, Kennedy Thompson. And then we have 4 seniors, and they've all been here all 4 years with me, the 4 seniors, and they've done about any type of part that I asked them to do. For instance, Jordan Miklich, if there's a big guy, we always had him, whether it was Frankenstein or anything. But Alex Doran, Jordan Miklich, Sage Peterson, and Grayson Binger. All right, let's give them a hand.
Mr. Brink will now present the FFA award.
At this time, I'd like to recognize the students that received certificates and medals at the state FFA convention earlier in April. In order to be recognized for a gold, they have to be in the top 10%, silver top 25%, and bronze in the top 40%. First of all, natural resources. The team placed 13th out of 59 teams with 201 individuals. Wyatt Johnson, silver, 43rd. Bronze, 53rd. Peyton Banger, 64th. Bronze. And Cole, 67th. Bronze. Floriculture team placed 15th out of 55 and bronze with 174 individuals. April Hamilton, 23rd. Silver. Stone, 55th, bronze. Our farm management team placed 8 out of 30. Silver place overall, 102 individuals. Chase Mitchell led the team with 24th, silver. Boston was 33rd, bronze. Jordan is 36th bronze. The Vet Science team placed 16th bronze out of 59 teams, 200 individuals. Riley was 36th individually, silver. And Matthew Stanley was 48th silver. The agronomy team placed 6th out of 37. They were silver team, 114 individuals. Isabel Close was 7th individually, gold rating. Grant Hamilton and Chelsea Hofer tied, and they placed silver, 17th and 18th, respectively. The meats team come forward, please. The meats evaluation team placed 1st on a 32 team, gold rating, 102 individuals. Anthony was 1st place individual with a gold rating. Bailey Cole was 3rd individually. And Allie and Cameron tied for 16th, silver rating. And just to give you a little information, there were 5 chapters that had 2 students on the stage. They recognized 10 students on the stage at a time. 5 chapters had 2 students. We had Anthony and Bailey up there, and our other 2 were tied for 16th with another team that had number 11. And so when they were going through the team places, I wasn't that confident that we were going to be 1st overall, but we were by team problem, and Anthony and Bailey were quite a little higher than some other scores. So congratulations. They will be representing the South Dakota FFA at the National Convention in October. Now I'd like to recognize Jordan Micklage for 3rd place silver finishing in forestry management and production. April Hamilton in diversified livestock production, bronze rating.
Education bronze rating. And now I'd like to recognize four students on the national level. This past week, we went to Oklahoma City and participated in the national land and home site evaluation. Out of 92 teams from 34 different states, 360 individuals, Allie Binger placed fourth high individual. Fourth out of 360, Bailey E. Nander, 16th.
Now we're going to go through the athletic awards. Each coach will come up and give a summary on their season, present some awards. Our first award will be the Cross Country Awards presented by Ms. McNeil.
Congratulate the seniors on graduation this weekend. You've come a long way since seventh grade math, huh?
Yeah.
This year's cross country team consisted of one senior, Caitlin Boomsma, juniors, Craig Mallon and Cassie Buhals, sophomores, Allie Binger, Ashlyn Otto, Brittany Holfer, and Tyler Schoen, eighth graders, Bailey Binger and Logan Gilbert, and seventh graders, Sydney Maynard and Colin McNeil. Before I hand out these awards, I want to thank my runners for their hard work. Craig and Tyler competed solely in cross country. The other runners doubled up with either volleyball or football. And neither is an easy task. I also want to thank Mr. Berry for his help with the season, setting up the schedule, lining up vehicles, and driving the bus. And this year, unfortunately, our schedule didn't mesh so well with the volleyball schedule, so the girls who doubled up were limited in the meets they could participate in. They also found this year had a new challenge of the new distance of 5,000 meters versus the 4,000 that they participated in the last year, in the last couple years. Junior high boys also juggled the challenges of football with cross country. Letter winners this year are Craig Mallon and Brittany Holfer. Like I said, the junior high boys, they competed in both football and cross-country, and Mr. McGillery was generous enough to let those boys run cross-country practice on Wednesday. I know Craig and Tyler certainly enjoyed having a few more kids running with them on Wednesdays. My most improved runner this year goes to a young man, started off the season. I could tell that he had gained a great amount of confidence in the running, in his running over the summer. He unfortunately ran only part of the season before he got hurt in football. But the meets he did run in, he took almost 2 minutes off of his time from last year. So I look forward to hopefully a healthy year next year, and hopefully he can compete an entire cross-country season. My most improved runner goes to Logan Gilbert. Determination Award. Last year I started the Determination Award. This award is what cross country is all about. Having the drive to get up and run those miles in the summer and every day in practice. This young man has been running for a few years, and the majority of the miles he's put in has been by himself. Running 6 miles by himself is not easy. But to do it when no one is there to run with you and to push yourself to make you makes it even tougher. Yet he did it every day in practice, and it showed him his times. I'm awarding this year's Determination Award to Craig Mellon. Craig is also being awarded the MVP this year. It speaks for itself. Craig placed 5th in our conference, 10th in our region, where he ran his best time ever. Took him to the state meet for the 3rd year in a row. I'm looking forward to his senior year and to see what next fall brings as far as teammates and competition for us. So congratulations, Craig.
This year's Patriot Volleyball Squad had an excellent season. The team had several individuals that broke school records and helped leave their mark in the season. The team finished 21-9, which broke the record for the best record in most wins in school history. The team also set new records in serves attempted and made, spikes attempted and made, and also kills. There's also 2 new match records, which include the most aces against Aberdeen Christian and the most kills against Samboyne Central Woonsocket. In addition to the records, the team finished as the 281 Conference Champion for a 3rd straight year. They also secured the 281 Conference Tournament Championship and were the runners-up in the Sanford Pentagon Tournament in Sioux Falls and then just in the District 4B Tournament. This year's letter wearing includes seniors Sage Peterson, Caitlin Boonsma, Shaylin Steinhauser. Juniors include Kylie Gross, April Hamilton, Aaron Berry, Corey Cheddar, Cassie Buchholz. Sophomores include Allie Binger, Bailey Enander, Cameron Binger, Ashlyn Otto, Bailey Cole, and Brittany Hofer. Freshmen included Chelsea Hofer, and student manager this year was Christy Miklich. This year we had five players named to all conference teams. First team goes to Sage Peterson and Shaylin Steinhauser. Second team went to Caitlin Boonsma. Third team went to Aaron Berry. And honorable mention selection was Allie Binger. Each year, the South Dakota Volleyball Coaches Association recognizes senior players that have played for at least 3 years and have had a cumulative GPA of 3.5. We have one recipient of this award, and that goes to Shaylin Steinhauser. New this year, the Volleyball Coaches Association recognizes teams that have a cumulative 3.5 GPA. And it's interesting, the Lady Volleyball, Patriot Volleyball team was one of only 20 schools in Class B to receive this award. So seniors, can you please come forward and receive the certificate on behalf of the school? Each year, the Aberdeen News, American News, chooses an all-area volleyball squad. We had one player named the squad this season, that was Sage Pearson. I also want to recognize a couple of players. Each fall, Power Promotions, which is a magazine, sort of like Hanson Anderson for basketball, if you're familiar with that, comes out with a magazine. And each year they ask coaches to nominate players to be on the cover of the magazine. And this last season we had a couple players get selected, Sage Pearson and Shaylin Steinhauser. So I'd like to just recognize them for their accomplishment being on the cover. Now to our team awards. The first award I'd like to give out is the best offensive player. And obviously when you have good seasons, it's hard to pick just one player, so this is going to be given to two players. Both of these players had a great year and played big roles in our rotation some way. The first player really played a big role in our rotation. Her presence was felt each match out. She averaged 2.84 kills per set, had 56 aces and 60 total blocks. She finished her career with the most kills in the history of the volleyball program with 658 kills. The first award goes to Caitlin Boozma. The second player I'd like to recognize is a player that once again has played a valuable role in our program the last 4 years. She's led our team in assists at 3.96 assists per set. This player was very valuable in running our offense the last 4 years. She finished her career with 1,316 set assists, which ranks first all time in the school, and the second best offensive player award goes to Sage Pearson. Next award I'd like to give out is our best defensive player award. This player was the backbone of our back row the last 4 seasons. She led the team in digs this season with 564 for the year, which averaged out to about 5.9 digs per set. On top of that, she served 95% from the line with 31 aces. She finished her career with a total of 1,516 digs, which ranks first all time again in school. This year's best defensive player is Shaylin Steinhauser. And we like to promote, the girls and I like to promote hustle in all our practices and matches, and as a coach, we like to see them give 110% in both areas. This particular player did that just that during the season. She was always hustling every time she stepped on the court. This player provides some great leadership and hustle in the back row, and this year's award goes to Shaylin Steinhauser. We have a second hustle award. The second player also played a great deal in our rotation. This player averaged 2.43 kills per set, 48 serves, 279 digs, and she currently sits fifth all time in kills and digs. We are lucky to have this player one more year, and that second award goes to Aaron Berry. Again, I preach to the players every day. We serve in practice. You know, serving the big thing in volleyball can basically make or break a match, as they know. This year's team served 90%, had 291 ace serves. The best server award goes to a player that had 97% accuracy, had 49 ace serves. She finished her career being the all-time leader in aces and served with Hitchcock Dillon, and this year's serving award goes to Sage Peterson. And again, it's always hard to pick a most improved player because everybody puts in so much time over the summer and during the season. They improve some type of the game in some respect. This particular player came off the bench for us and played the back row. You know, the more she played, the more comfortable she became. She stepped in a couple of times to play the libero spot for us. She ended up the season with 191 digs, or 2.27 digs per set. She's going to look upon to provide some depth in the back row the next couple of seasons. This year's most improved player goes to Bailey Cole. On the behalf of the team and myself, I would personally like to thank Coach Binger for all her hard work that she has put into our program the last 4 years. We're going to greatly miss her next year. And so I'd like to give her a round of applause for all the hard work she's done.
Just a little recap on our football season. We had 15 young men that I have a lot of respect for because this is a very physical sport. It's demanding, and I'm not a real nice guy sometimes. And with that being said, you take a look at our roster this year. 15 young men that had the misfortunate opportunity at times to go and play rosters of 50 and 60 kids. And that's a disadvantage. But not one of these young men stepped away from the challenge. That tells me a lot about their character and who they are. Our season didn't go as planned. You know, we went 2-6, but there's promise there. We are going to build, and you look around, and it's intimidating to see banners of state championships and state appearances. And we're going to get there. It just is going to take a little bit of patience and some time. And I like to think the reward that we got out of this year, that not only was we got physically tougher because we had to, but there's very few teams, I think, in the state that can say our schedule consisted of 5 teams that played for a state championship this year. And that was a pretty real moment, I think, for our guys to see that. So first off, I would like all of my football players, junior high and high school, to please stand here. This year's team captains, stay seated, gentlemen. We have Boston Knipling, Chase Bixler, Grayson Binger, and Riley Binger. You know, being a captain, you go out and you exemplify hard work, dedication to your team and to the game of football. And gentlemen, I think you did a nice job with that. I also like to thank some people that sometimes get overlooked. There's one part of our team that's very disgusting, and that's being a football manager, because they get to deal with them when they stink and they're sweaty and they're gross and everything else. The first person, I think he's been doing this quite a while from my understanding. He's kind of the machine here. He gets all the stuff out on the field and kind of lets me know when I'm not doing it right. And so AJ, thank you very much for your time. Also had 4 young ladies, Dawson Otto, Ashton Otto, Sky Chaplin, and Trajan Fui, that I think they learned what the definition of smell is. But they did a fabulous job for us, and I appreciate your efforts, so thank you, ladies, for that. So I'll just introduce the awards here that we have. I'll start off with our all-conference. We placed 5 on the first-team all-conference, 2 honorable mentions, and 3 first-teams. Our honorable mention this year were Grant Hamilton and Grayson Bigger. Team, all conference, 281. Chase Bixler, Boston Knipling, and Riley Baker. Our team awards, which are voted on by our fellow players, we have 5 to give out this year. I agree with what Mr. Ott said. The most improved award you'd love to give to every one of your players because you hope they have improved at some facet of the game. And the individual that got this, I don't know, about week 3 or 4, I called him in, sat him down, and I said, you're going to play quarterback the next game. You know that look that a deer has right before it gets hit? Well, Grant, come get your most improved award. Our top lineman this year, kind of a jack of all trades, senior, has been through some good and some bad, and maybe the seniors, you know, the season didn't go the way we wanted, but you hung in there and you fought, and our top, most valuable lineman is Grayson Bigger. Our most valuable offensive player, very good athlete, works very hard, team captain, and he told me a lot about his character, because the last game of the year against Westminster Springs, it's a torrential downpour, and they're enormous, and I think I pulled Grant from the game and said, Chase, I need you to play quarterback so he doesn't get killed. And at that time, Chase was playing running back because we moved Chase and Boston in the backfield because we needed our beef back there. And with that, that kind of told me a lot that, you know, he looked at me and said, absolutely. As voted on by the team, the most valuable offensive MVP this year is Chase Bixler. Our defensive MVP flies around the field, always in there making a play. Sometimes I don't know if all the screws are actually attached. You do hear him all over the field. He finished, I think, the season with 78 tackles, had some big plays. Our defensive MVP this year is Boston Knipling. Award. I don't know if this is a new award for you, but it was something Coach McGivory and I thought about the vision we have for our program. And that vision is to obviously do the things the Patriot way. So this award is called the Patriot Award. The qualifications are hard work, dedication, coachability, that never quit, never die attitude. And the individual that received this award, we feel exemplifies all of those characteristics, if not more. And he is not the biggest, he's not the strongest, but he is a hard-working young man, and that to me goes a long, long way. So I don't know if this is the first annual Patriot Award or not, but for the football team it is, and that award goes to Riley Binger. We have two final awards to give out. South Dakota Football Coaches Association recognizes the academic All-State. With the criteria is you gotta have a 3.5 and play 3 years of varsity football. My honor, privilege, hard work, dedication, all goes together. Academic All-State is Chase Bisler. And the last award, the South Dakota Football Coaches Association likes to recognize a friend of football. And it's somebody that kind of does stuff behind the scenes, doesn't ask for anything in return, just does it because they care about the program and about kids. The individual we're giving it to this year attended every game, road and home. Did the little things to kind of help us, but he was willing to film our games for us every single week. So I would like to thank you, Ted Price, for that commitment to our program and offer you the Friend of Football Award.
Danielle Wright. Amanda Vogel. Cheerleaders, and they were Kennedy Topsha, Kylie Gross, Cassie Buholz. Cameron Binger. Okay, Lady Patriot Basketball Awards. I've been looking forward to this. Little summary, we finished 13-9, overall, second in the conference. We ended up having some very strong leadership on the court this year from our seniors, and I want to congratulate them as well on the graduation. But overall, all the players that we had out this year are so selfless and enjoy playing the game, and I liked what one of the other coaches did to have everybody that played stand. So funny if all the girls basketball 7th through 12th would stand. And I just want to say a few thank yous to people, because I think I missed a few on Parents' Night. We can't forget anyone, hopefully. So first off, the fans, and then all the players for their hard work, because I know there were practices at 6 in the morning or earlier, and everybody was there. Not so bright-eyed and bushy-tailed, but they were there, and whatever workout we had planned, they did it, and no questions asked. I thank them for that. All of our bus drivers, refs for the junior high tournaments, JV games for doubleheaders, the scorekeepers, the pep band that played at a lot of our home games, stats keepers, all the 7th and 8th graders, mostly the 7th graders, for wet mopping the floors, taking care of getting equipment on and off the bus, even though we forgot a couple times. We didn't forget after that. Filling water bottles for the varsity, sitting, supporting the varsity, that means a lot. And Christine Miklich for always keeping video for our games. I know Jen helped her out, but we watched a lot of game tape and stuff too, so I think we need to give her a and especially my assistant coach, Jason Bannister, for listening to me and with all of his great ideas. And it was a good team. So I will turn it over to you to announce letter winner.
So just stand.
She asked if I wanted to say something, and I just told her, be careful what you ask for. Letter winners this year. Jalen Steinhauser. Caitlin Berisma. Sage Peterson. Aaron Berry. Sinead Peterson. Sky Chaplin. Allie Binger. Bailey Enander. Tyler Schoen. Bailey Cole, Ashlyn Otto, Brittany Hofer, Dawson Otto, and Chelsea Hofer.
Okay, I'll hand out the all-conference awards now. We had two girls get honorable mention for the 281 all-conference. Allie Binger. Caitlin Boomsma. Second team recipient, Aaron Berry. And first team goes to Shaylin Steinhauser. Academic All-State that the other coaches have
mentioned, we also had one girl receive that award, and that goes to Shaylin Steinhauser. Okay. So the first award I'm going to give is called the Hustler Award. And this individual gave her maximum effort every moment. Both ends of the court, practice or games, JV games or varsity, pushed herself and in turn ended up pushing her teammates. She did everything she was asked to do by myself or Coach Bannister to the best of her ability. I can remember times she would come off of the court dripping sweat, sprinting sideline to sideline, end to end, dripping sweat, never once asked for a substitution. She always wore a smile, and for some reason, she wore shorts and cowboy boots to and from practice. This year's hustler, Sky Chaplin. Next award's best defense. We stressed defense a lot this year, so we had to give out one of these. At the first basketball meeting we had at the beginning of the season, Coach and I asked everybody in the room, what's your favorite part about basketball? And this girl stood up and said, defense. And then the trend continued, and a lot of girls ended up saying defense. She was one of our starters. She was asked to play several different positions in the press that we like to run. She averaged 3.4 rebounds a game, one block a game, and two steals a game. She was called upon often to guard the opponent's best player, whether they were a post or guard or a ball handler, and she never stepped down from the challenge. She even surprised herself when she stole the ball from Maya Sellin. This year's best defense goes to Caitlin Boomsma. Most improved. Like some of the other coaches have said, there's a lot of girls that I felt could have got this award, and it was hard to choose just one. But I felt that this particular player impacted the team the most. She spent countless hours in the gym in the off season, even during season. She became a very vital part of our offense and our defense. She averaged 7.5 points a game, shot the team's highest free throw percentage with 88%, shot 50% from the three-point line, had 1.5 assists a game, and led the team in steals with 2.5 a game. It was difficult to bring the ball up the court without her in the game, and for only getting her feet wet, playing varsity a little bit the year before, this individual stepped up and became a true threat to our opponents and someone her teammates could count on. The most improved player for the 2015-2016 season is Allie Binger. And finally, the MVP. At the beginning of the season, I handed out a player's handbook. And at the first page, it said, every game, all the time. And that was kind of our motto that we lived by. You work hard every game, all the time. You know, anything involving basketball, that was the motto. And this player seemed to be the most consistent. She averaged 82% from the free throw line, shooting 160 free throws on the season. Just to put that in perspective, the next player below her shot 43. As a guard, she led the team in rebounds with 3.7,
averaged 2 steals a game, and led the team on average with 13.3 points a game. She always gave 100%, whether she's on offense or defense, in practice or in a game. Her teammates looked to her to lead them. She led by example, and coach and I would often say, watch her, watch how she does this, watch the position she's in. She always had a great attitude and really enjoyed every moment she got to spend playing the game. She always played with so much passion and heart. I hope that rubbed off on everyone around her. And now she's going to continue to contribute to a new team at Trinity Lutheran in Ellendale next fall. Your Lady Patriot MVP for the 2015-2016 season, Shaylin Steinhauser.
These will be the awards for the 2015-2016 boys basketball. Quick recap of the season. We were 10-12 overall, 6-5 against the conference opponents, finished the consolation championship in the 2-1 tournament. We continued our winning streak against our neighbors up north, and we played great against some pretty tough teams. We were down by 4 at halftime to the state champion Warner Monarchs. We had James Valley late into the 4th. Woolsey Westington late into the 4th. Sanborn Central late into that game. So one thing we noticed is we needed to do a better job developing depth. We needed to get stronger. We needed to get faster. And I got to thank our guys for the time and the commitment they've made into the room up north up here. We've done a good job expanding it through this school project. And we've raised some money, got some new equipment, and these gentlemen are taking advantage of it. The letter winners for the 2015-2016 season. Please stand when I say your name. Hold your applause to the end, please. Grayson Binger, Chase Bitzler, Boston Knipling, Jordan Miklich, Craig Mallon, Anthony Anderson, our stats manager, Peyton Binger, Zach Binger, Wyatt Johnson, Caleb Warner, our student manager, Cody Anderson, Dawson Gamm, Grant Hamilton, Ty Hofer, Peyton Nelson, our videographer, and Kobe Stoner. Thank you. When it came time to try to figure out the basketball awards, I was myself kind of a deer in the headlight. Called up Kenny. God, what did we give out last year? I don't remember. He gave me a list of the things that he gave out. And some of it fit what we were trying to do, and some of it didn't. So I sat down and tried to figure out what awards we needed to give out to move this program in the direction that I wanted to go to. We focused on team. We focused on hard work and commitment to one another. So the following are the awards. I'll list all awards that the player got and then come up and get them together. First award was our Mr. Patriot Award. I wanted this to be our leader on and off the field, somebody that embodied what it was to me to be a patriot. Second award this gentleman's gonna get is most assists. The third award this gentleman gets to receive, one that I'm proud of, the academic All-State. Again, needed to be a senior, maintain a 3.5 GPA, and be a part of the team for 3 years. He was also voted by the conference as a first team member, and he scored his 1,000th career point this season. Chase Bixler. Thank you.
all that means to you? Okay. Next award I'm giving out goes back to that team concept of working hard, doing the little things to help get some victories. And one of the stats that I think symbolizes that is rebounding. So the award for most rebounds goes to Mr. Boston Knipling. Going on to what all the other coaches said, a lot of these awards, pretty straightforward. Most improved one is it's the one you want all your kids to get. It's the one as a coach that tells you you're doing your job when you see all these kids making progress to achieve their goals. And we had a lot of commitments made by everybody to spend extra time in that weight room. And so this one for me was really hard. I wanted to give it to everyone, and then I remembered I don't believe in participation awards, so I didn't. Most improved player is a kid that didn't get a lot of minutes last year. It was a kid that I asked over the summer to spend time working on a spot-up shooting. It's a gentleman that shot 43% from behind the line, averaged 8.5 points a game. Craig Mallon, come up and get the most improved player. Next award, again, going back to the defensive-minded teamwork hustle, will be the Defensive Player of the Year award. Constantly told this kid that speed's a good thing when it's controlled. Love your athleticism. Do some of this. But man, does this kid hustle. He sees the floor so well, especially from a defensive standpoint. And I don't know that I've seen anybody in a single season take as many charges as this individual. It had to be frustrating for guards that got past our first defender thinking they had a layup, and he swooped in and flopped. But he got it every time, so much that I actually encouraged all of our team to go to Byron Bible Camp. Because I think they teach it there. Ty Hofer, come up and get your Defensive Player of the Year. Just two more awards. This next award was something that I wanted to create as kind of an up-and-comer award to show my appreciation to a 7th or 8th grade basketball player that's moving on to the next level with us. Somebody, again, that embodies what I want a young Patriot basketball player to be, on and off the field, character counts kind of guy. And we definitely had a good group of 8th graders this year. This, again, is a gentleman, thanks to football season. A little slow start because of his ankle, but he was at every practice, rehabbing it, working hard, and the improvements that he made over the summer showed through finally when he got the opportunity to step foot on the court. Logan Gilbert, our junior. And the last award. Those of you counting, I think that's six. This, again, is an award that was created due to the sacrifice and the commitment that these individuals made to the weight room. I preached it in season, I made it mandatory in season, and strongly encouraged it out of season. This gentleman is up over 125, 130 lifts. Our next closest is mid-60s, low 70s. This gentleman took his deadlift from 230 pounds to over 400 in about 6 months. We continue to make that kind of progress. I don't care if we've got 18 kids or 50 kids, we'll compete.
So our Man of Steel Award goes to Mr. Caleb Warner. To wrap things up, I'd like to thank Bill for being our bookkeeper, bus driver, AD, the guy that let us stop after the games to eat. Thank you, Bill, for all your help this season. I'd also like to extend a special thank you again to our stats manager, Peyton Binger, our student manager, Cody Anderson, and our videographer, Mr. Peyton Nelson. And lastly, for the four seniors that are leaving, Chase, Boston, Grayson, Jordan. Thank you for helping make this an easy first year for me. Thank you for helping lead these young individuals to commit themselves a little bit more than what we had in the past. We'll miss you, even though I didn't tell you that earlier, Boston. I smiled at him and he didn't like that. So I'll say it, we'll miss you. Thank you.
The next award isn't on the agenda here, but I'm honored to offer this one because at one time in my life when I was significantly thinner, I was one. So I'd like to recognize two people that do wrestle for Redfield Dolan, but they do it out of pride as a Hitchcock Tulare Patriot. So first off, would Colin McNeil come up here? He lettered. Wrestling and needs to recognize he's a seventh grader. If it's any indication of how good he is and will become, I do believe both of his older brothers qualified for state this year. So, better get going, buddy. And the other one, we have an award here. This individual, doesn't get a lot of opportunities to attend basketball games and things because he's at wrestling. But in the time that he is here, he does support our school in a lot of things. He's here every morning lifting weights bright and early, I think, with Bailey and Caleb. He exemplifies toughness. He exemplifies what it means to be a wrestler. And unless you've actually done the sport, it is often difficult to really realize the torture that you put yourself through. There were times I would look at him, I think he weighed 106 pounds. I think that was my birth weight, but good. And you just look at him and he looks frail and weak and tired, and that's a commonality. And he asked me one day, he's like, "Can I go run? I'm a little overweight." Okay, go run. But this should show the support and the respect that he has earned, because we did all as a school go up to watch him wrestle, and he did not disappoint. And on top of that, he did qualify for the state wrestling tournament in Rapid City this year. So it is with my honor to present the Wrestling MVP Award to Riley Binger.
Before we get started on these track awards, we first need to recognize our academic All-State. The thing with track and having our awards ceremony is the fact that our season is not over. It doesn't get over until school is done. So as far as recognizing academic All-State, it will be Shayla Steinhauser, so we'd like to congratulate her. Also, with that being said, would all the track athletes please stand up, because their season is not technically over yet, so we letter kids, but there's always that opportunity for other kids to letter. So we have the region track meet, which is coming up on Thursday of this coming up week. Just so you know, the track meet for tomorrow was canceled once again, because our season always depends on the weather. And as you know, our weather's been horrible this year. Please sit down. Thank you. I said that to Coach McNeil. I said, I think this rivals the 1997, and some of you who had kids at that time can relate to that, because it was always, we get up in the morning, what's the weather going to be like? We've had one day this year where the wind hasn't blown 20 to 30 miles an hour. And, you know, those conditions, I mean, we went through a whole football season and all these years, and I don't remember ever having usually a beautiful evening for football, but every time there's a track forecast, or track meet forecast that we're supposed to go to, the forecast is terrible. I just looked in the extended forecast, and Thursday is 68 degrees and windy and rain. So we should be used to it by now, but that's coming up for you. Just a little bit about the season. Once again, we start talking about most improved and all that stuff. You know, we go through, it's easy for us to tell who's improved and who isn't by looking at times, looking at hard work. Every one of you guys works hard. Every one of you improves in some way, shape, or form. We can start off at the beginning of the year and we can say, here's the time they ran here. Here's the distance they've thrown here. And we can see improvements going on throughout the season. I'd like to thank the seniors. First of all, I'd like to thank Sage Peterson for coming back out the track. You know, there's a lot of seniors get to this point. I can't blame them. You know, track is a thankless sport. I mean, we go out and we run, and I'm sorry, if you're not a parent, you're probably not going to the track meet. You know, you go and see the people in the stands, and a lot of it, 95% of it, is your parents. Okay, we go to a football and a basketball game, and there's a lot of people that want to come watch it. So for you to come back out for track, Sage, I appreciate it 100%. She shows great hard work, leadership, and it's good to have that. It's good to show the younger kids that, hey, you know what? I go out for track. I might not be the number one athlete, but you know what? She puts forth a hard work every day, and that speaks volumes to the younger kids. So thank you for that. Go on. The two seniors that we have, the other two seniors, Shaylin Steinhauser and Clay Martin, have put in hours and hours and hours and hours and hours. They've been out for 6 years. I'm sure they wanted to quit. Maybe not Clay, because Clay is hardcore track. Shaylin, I know she's had moments in her mind where she's going, I don't know, I don't want to do this anymore. I told Shaylin and I told all the track athletes, I want me to see you be so fatigued that you collapse on the ground. Then I know you're working hard. They're working hard, I realize that. So the other day we're at the conference track meet and I looked out across and we ran a relay, and then a little while later she had to run the open half, and I looked out and I couldn't find her, and I see this person laying on the ground all by herself. And I walked over and she's just, I don't even know what she mumbled, but I knew she had reached that point. So the hard work that you guys put in, all of you, not just the seniors, all of you that you put in, is greatly appreciated by Coach and I. You know, we go through a season, we look for PRs. You know, you don't always win. We go to certain track meets, there's, you know, a prime example is some of our younger kids, where do I go? I would like to run this event. There's only 7 people in there. I think I can place this time. And then they get up there, and there's 15, and they're stuck in the event. Chase found that out a few years ago. And so you go back and forth, and they try to find their little niche, and we have kids that try everything. And that's a great thing about track. There are a lot of different things you can try. So I appreciate all that. PRs are something that we look for. We might not win medals, but hey, you know, I know it's not always the thing that kids like nowadays is the pat on the back and say, good job. But you know what, good job for a lot of you. Good job for you sticking it out and the hard work that you put in. We'll get to our awards here. Our first award, like everybody else said, of course, your MVP or your most improved is the hardest one, because like we said before, everybody improves. But our girl MVP, or our girl's most improved this year, is a young lady who every meet that we go to, you can see she gets stronger and stronger and stronger. She doesn't always like to try the events we put her in. I can tell by the look on her face she would love to be a sprinter, because everybody wants to be a sprinter because your races are done within 12 to 15 seconds or 20 seconds. Anything over that is not fun usually. But she works hard every day, even when she's hurt. And I can tell she's hurt in her eyes. I say, are you all right, Ashlyn? Yep. And she works hard. So our hardest work, or our most improved athlete is Ashlyn Otto. For our hardest worker, I kind of alluded to it a little bit ago. She came back out for track. She may not always get to run the events she wants to run. She would love to be a sprinter. No, she would love to not run. But we go to track practice every day. And she's out there, she busts her tail. She works her rear end off. And I tell you what, it speaks volumes, like I said before, when you show that leadership to everybody. Our hardest worker for the girls is Sage Peterson. Our most valuable girl athlete, she's been out for 6 years. She's had the opportunities to qualify for state. She's had the opportunity to be on the threshold of qualifying for state. She works hard. Sometimes she doesn't have the faith in herself. We have to build her up. But I know she believes that she can do it in her heart. We have another region track meet coming up, and the opportunities are there. We just have to find out where the opportunity is. She's put in a lot of time, a lot of effort. We appreciate all of her hard work over the years, and she's been a great leader for us. Our MVP for the girls is Shaylin Steinhauser. For our boys, most improved. Like I said before, we got a lot of them, a lot of kids out, a lot of opportunities for people to improve. This young man has tried about anything we've told him to do. And I always say at the beginning of the year, hey, I'll put you in whatever you want to do. But then there's going to be a point in time where we're probably going to have to try something else. We don't always like to try the 2 mile relay. That's probably a swear word in track, I think. I don't know. But this individual has worked hard. He's brought his times down in the 200. He's brought his times down in the 400, which he just started to try. Did the 2 mile relay down in Howard Wood. Ran the best time on the team. Our most improved track athlete is Grant Hamilton. Hardest worker. Coach and I sat down and we go through it, and I think it was pretty unanimous when we came up with this. Well, it'll probably surprise him a little bit, I don't know. But this young man has never been out for track, came out this year. If you've seen where he was at the beginning of the year compared to where he is now, he believes in himself. And every time he steps out on the track, things happen for him. And his times come down a little bit each time. He's not the fastest, but he works hard. When we're done with the workout, he's ready to go. Our hardest worker this year is Anthony Anderson. And our most valuable boy, track athlete, state qualifier this year, two events already, long jump and triple jump. The kid eats, sleeps, and drinks track. He likes track. I said to him, we had a track meet tomorrow. I give the seniors the opportunity because we have receptions to go to. I said, Clay, you going to the track meet? Yep. No hesitation whatsoever. He works hard. He tries anything I've asked him to. He did the 2 mile relay also. And his mom and dad didn't even know it until he got down there. They were ready to leave. He's always done whatever I've asked him to. He's worked hard. He's been a great leader. Our MVP for track, boys, is Clay Martin. And then the last thing I'd like to do is I'd like to take the opportunity to thank the fans, parents for coming out, supporting the track team, the kids, you guys who work hard. I would love to give everybody an award, but like Coach McGilvery said, well, we don't hand out participation awards, but you all have opportunities to win awards at track meets. And I'd also like to thank the opportunity, or give the opportunity to thank Coach McNeil for all her hard work and wisdom this season. I appreciate it. She does a lot of the little things for me. That doesn't go unrecognized, so thank you very much.
I do have an apology. I did forget to announce something during football. It happens. It's been a long week. But we did have a young man that was selected to go to the Riggs Premier Football Combine, which is basically a skills combine like you see on the NFL when they try to draft people. And he was invited to attend this. He went a few weeks ago down to Sioux Falls and got to compete with some of the best football players in South Dakota. So Caleb, if you would stand up and get recognized for that, I think that's a really noble honor. Remarks here. First off, seniors, if you would take a stand up for one more ovation, because you've done a nice job as a Hitchcock to the Patriots. Just a reminder, graduation is Saturday at 2 o'clock, right here in Tulare. Send these young men and young women off on their future endeavors. I think they've served our school well. Academically and athletically. And by the number of certificates I signed in the last couple days, at least 150. That speaks volumes of the type of kids that we have in the school, athletically and academically. And we try to promote team here. Our school has a great vision. We're going in the right direction. We have a lot of good things from a new school to great students and a strong community support. And it's hard to thank everybody, so I'm going to try something new this year. Okay? We've recognized all the students, but sometimes we forget about those people that are our silent supporters. Some are more vocal than others. So first off, will all the parents please stand up? Yep, you have to participate, sorry. Will brothers and hold on. Will brothers and sisters stand up? Aunts and uncles? Grandpas and grandmas? Friends? Teachers? Coaches? You individuals who are standing, I need to thank you because it's your support, it's your guidance and your structure that has allowed for this event to be so successful because you push our kids to be the best. Now, students, take a look around you. Look how many people have your back. So I think, students, you need to give it a very welcoming applause to these leaders. So I thank you all for your support and coming tonight. Have a good evening and a safe drive home.